you ever had trouble rendering a space without windows? Today, I will show you how to go from this to this. So here is the situation. We have no windows in this bathroom. It's quite easy to do an interior render if you have windows. You add environmental light. Everything looks well from the beginning. Unfortunately, it is not the case today. First of all, we have to keep the lighting balance. We need to add different sorts of lighting. The idea is to create a layering effect. Let me show you. Well, start by adding the main source of light in this bathroom, the downlights. We'll choose corona light for this rectangle shape. Adjust the height. There are four sources of ceiling lights in this project, so let's copy it around as an instance. We can use light selection to make copying easier. Let's add the light select to add it to the light mix. Let's call it downlights. Add the lights. Start interactive rendering. There is some noise. Let's use the region rendering to test if it appears when rendering longer. Yeah, we don't have to worry about it. The lighting is definitely not strong enough. Let's increase the value. 1.5 is perfect. The next lights we'll add are the LED around the suspended ceiling. These sorts of lights add mood to the space and highlight the design. We can set the width to 3 cm and center this. It should be in this hole between the wardrobe and the suspended ceiling. And now, let's create another one, also 3 cm, and both lights to the new light layer. We can call it LED. Start interactive rendering so we can adjust the lights. Of course, we need to move the light up. It is too strong. Let's reduce the intensity. Okay, 0.75 works nicely. And let's adjust the color now. The trick is that if you want to create outstanding images, you should not only use different intensities of lights, but also use cold and warm colors of them. Thanks to this, you will create an interesting contrast and shape the space better. Okay, we have another LED light above the mirror. Let's use the rectangle light again. Adjust the height. Add the light to the new layer. We can name it mirror. Let's see the preview. We can copy the color of the lights from the LED layer. I will make it more intense. Yeah, better. It shouldn't be too strong to maintain harmony. I think we can try to add a bit of blue color to these lights. This blue should not be too strong though, as we want to keep the natural effect. I've already told you many times that blue and orange are a great combination. Also, the bathroom has shape and it actually works great without windows. But that's not everything. We need to add a pendant light. We can see that this model has corona light added, so we can add the model to the new layer straight away. Let's call it a pendant lamp. And start interactive rendering. Let's increase the intensity. You can notice that we cannot see light here. It's probably on the rest layer. It happens sometimes. Anyway, I think we need the light to be even stronger. Let me show you the lights one by one. Awesome. It really works, isn't it? We can change the pendant light to something warmer though. Let's copy the color, but I make it less intense. Perfect. We'll add the first reflection to the toilet and the second to the cosmetics on the basin. Let's create a rectangle light above the glass jar first. Don't forget to uncheck the options to make the light invisible in the camera. Change the option to include. And add the objects. Okay, now copy the light and move it toward the toilet. To get the best result, we need to rotate it to lighten up the edge of the toilet. I'll move it down as well to create a sharp effect. Great, now remove the objects from the list and add the toilet. Add the lights to the new layer. We can name it Reflections. Start interactive rendering. By the way, if you want to learn how to design outstanding interiors like this, check out our new interior design course, where we cover everything from understanding trends in interior design, preparing together for the first meeting with the client, creating a functional plan, designing a concept, and finally, creating technical documentation to make just an idea to be alive. We decided to create this course with our friends from Fura Studio, who are practitioners and actually work in the profession. 70 lessons in total, more than 10 hours of content, and as always, some bonuses for you. You'll find the link in the corner and in the description below. Let's use the region to make rendering faster. Well, it's too strong for sure. Let's reduce the value. It should give us a delicate effect. It shouldn't be too strong. And it should be less warm as well. Let's adjust the color. Great, look how much it helps. It makes the object way more 3D. Let's assume that we have a camera from a different side. Even though we have the lights set up the same way as in the previous image, it doesn't look good in this example. Let me tell you, what is the biggest issue here? You can notice that our downlights made the wall look quite flat, and it's definitely not the look we want to go. So let's turn it off. Instead, we can hide the doors as they will not be visible in the camera or reflections. Next, let's add environmental light. And let's start interactive rendering. Let's turn off all other lights. This light looks way better and it makes the wall look more 3D. However, it is not strong enough. Let's increase the intensity. Okay, I make it blue, the same reason as before. Now let's turn on other lights and let's make some adjustments. LED light is too strong in this case, I reduce the strength. We can increase the mirror light though. 0.7 looks nice. Now the pendant lamp should be stronger as well. I like the effect it adds on the wall. 10 is perfect. I will make the reflection bluer as it imitates the environmental light. And a bit less strong as well. Another great trick is to add some extra light to expose some features. It's a common technique used in photography. As the wall is an important part of the design, I like to highlight that it is not plain and one-dimensional. I'll add extra light. I position it somewhere around the doors. Let's rotate it toward the direction of the wall. Adjust the height, change the option to include, and add the wall to the list. Great! Add the light to the new light layer. We can call it reflection 2. Let's prepare the effect. Okay, you can notice that the tiles are way more 3D, and this was our goal. Let's copy the blue color and adjust the intensity. We want it to look natural, so it cannot be too strong. Awesome, perfect output. Now you can see that we have a big black spot in the mirror reflection. We can add extra light to it to imitate the reflections from the door. Copy the light. Rotate and adjust the position. I'll make it higher. Delete the wall from the list and add the wardrobe instead. Now let's start interactive rendering and see the results. Cool, it looks way more interesting, but we need to adjust the dimensions a bit. Okay, better. The light is too strong though, let's reduce the intensity. I will adjust the position a bit to create a nicer reflection. Awesome! To learn more about interior designing, join the training I've mentioned before. Also, watch a tutorial where I cover interior visualization from start to finish or another video YouTube thinks you might like. Bye bye!